Hi, it's Susanna B. Troy. I wanted to talk to you about Mike Bloomberg. You know, last year he snuck in to a grand jury and testified about Haggerty. I mean, how cowardly and secretive. And I was going on about 62 emails that the mayor, they didn't want to share. Well, it turned out I was close. I'd had 62, probably 1,000, but hold that thought. It was actually Skip. His name is Anthony Skip Piscatelli. I might be mispronouncing his name. But he's a lobbyist, and he's gotten in trouble, and he's worked for Giuliani. There's definitely Kevin Sheekey's name comes up. And the reason I say I want to see 62,000 emails of Mike Bloomberg is because I want to see the emails that went back to the Republican Party when Bloomberg funneled money to Haggerty the election before. Because Mike Bloomberg's done this two elections in a row. Now, I'm going to give you links to everything. Give me time to put the links into this YouTube. And you're going to find a link to a very long comment I found posted in the New York Daily News that in so many words accuses Cy Vance of campaign improprieties himself and brings in Maura Keaney. And I'm going to give you articles to Jim Dwyer in the New York Times, Maura Keaney breaking, would I say breaking laws or just, let's say, lapse of integrity. And how she's lived high off of New York City government taxpayers. Now, you guys missed the union protest at City Hall, and I want to read a few things that they have on their flyer. The mayor announced cuts of 12% in city agency budgets for fiscal 2010-11, while he increased contracting costs by 27% in the last fiscal year. Spending snowballed 1,000%. On city time payroll projects where the feds just arrested outside consultants for stealing $80 million. The cost overruns alone on city time and 911 project top $1 billion. I'd say closer to $2 billion. Working and middle-class New Yorkers pay higher transit fare, sales and property tax, rent and water fees, while even strip clubs get tax breaks as the city neglects over $200 million a year in available recurring tax revenue from big businesses. The mayor rewarded some of his campaign workers with high-paid city jobs at the taxpayers' expense, gave them raises up to 20% after only 6 months on the job, and padded his office with outrageous expenses, including three executive chefs for $2,405,000 a year, $245,000 a year of taxpayer money. Cut the contracts. The city council should use its authority under the city charter to cut payments to contractors by 10%. 10% as Los Angeles and Chicago have done. Collect $200 million in taxes as the city is owed by big businesses. Hire more tax assessors and auditors to maximize revenue. Pass legislation requiring real job creation for any tax incentives. And the patronage payoffs and fat salaries in the mayor's office. I agree with all that. I thought you should know that. Also, we know that the mayor's been paying people extra, you know, giving them even double salaries, like three administrative assistants that were earning more than Commissioner Kelly. So I just wanted to share all that with you.